Wow. I was just wondering something, and it answered it in my head. It was so cool. I said to myself, I wonder how there are some things that I don't know about yet, and there's some things that I can't figure out, like healing and all that stuff yet, and I can't figure those out, but how am I such a connection with my higher powers and spirits? And I figured that out, because it just told me. Because I do this breathing exercise where I take the wind from my stomach, from my chest, up to my head. And when I put it in my head, I hold it there. And I can aim where I put my breath. I can aim where I put my attention. I can move my energy around my feet and my hands, up to my back, through my ribs, around my intestines. Like, the more I can visualize my body parts, the more I can actually take my person through it in whatever vehicle I want. It could be a spaceship and I'm going down a hallway and it's one of my veins. But as long as I can stay focused, I can do it and find a spot in my body and heal a pain. As long as I can picture it in my mind, it doesn't even turn into a belief then, because I already believe it because I'm doing it. I'm having fun doing it, and I go do something. Like, I take out a pain in my arm by like going and I shoot it. I don't shoot it with something that would hurt, because then the pain relief would hurt. So I do something like a love ray or something, like some kind of weird womp laser, and it fixes it. It heals. It's weird, but it works. So like, I was trying to think to myself, like, why am I so in touch with my higher powers than I am with, like, healing and stuff like that? But I figured it out. That happens to people who, like, open their crown chakra, and they're, like, I haven't completely opened my third eye because I can't visualize perfectly. I mean, of course, I could always visualize better. I mean, 360 vision is awesome, but there's more than that. There's in, out, and all around vision. There's the feeling of everything. There's more than that to do with the third eye. The third eye does so much more than just seeing visions and visualize. I mean, there's so much more, and I just know because I've seen it. Once it actually opened, it was like when you have your eyes open and you're squinting and you're looking through your eyelashes. That's how I have it open, and that's how well I can see with the 360 vision, and I just have it squinting. I'm squinting my third eye, and I'm knowing that it can open more. But I'm thinking the reason I have such power, and I feel I'm in the divine realm, and I literally know, but just want to say, think, or feel like I won the life game, because I won. I understand how to explain God, and God agrees with my definition. And if he doesn't, I would start having bad luck. And he doesn't disagree with my definition. In fact, I'm going to have great luck because he agrees with me. And he just wants me to teach it to people so people stop killing each other and stop polluting and stop hurting. I mean, because he's experienced so much, he doesn't want to do that anymore. He doesn't like killing. God doesn't like killing. He's killed as everybody. He's killed as us. You know, he's like, there's no difference between killing a bug than it is killing a person. It's just a different being is playing your role. It's like you were playing Yahtzee, and one person was the there's five dice, and there's five main dice, and each dice has the number, and each number is made up of ink, and each ink spot on the dice has particles. One has two, three, four, five, six. So those all have different amounts of whatever thing going on in them, or different climates, and the other ones don't accept the other. That's just what we are. We're just playing a game, and we need to learn how to accept each other. That's it. Accept each other and work together. That's it. Nothing more. If you disagree, you disagree. It never gets to the point where you fight against each other. Never. You just say, okay, well then I'll go over here and do it. And nobody says, no, I own right there. I'm using that spot. There's no more, no, that's my spot. There is no your spot. It's the earth. It's the earth. Everything, nobody owns anything, and they need to stop being so possessive, because if we are all one, everything is everyone's. And I know that's hard to do because you're living in the paradigm, but it's easy to break once you understand it. And you do it little by little by little. I love you guys. I wish I could help people because they're so blocked off. And even when I say something like this, I can feel that they don't want to talk to me because I'm saying some weird stuff that they don't understand. And I'm saying it so plainly, just like this, and they think I'm being rude or being an asshole. And I'm like, I'm not being an asshole. I love you so much. I'm trying to help you. Adult to adult. And they'll, like, be angry at me because it's like that feeling of, you know something I don't know, and why don't I know? If I would know, like, it sounds right, but why do you know and not me? Because they didn't put the effort in. I worked hard. I earned it. I mean, it's that simple. It's part of the game. I played well. I strategized. I learned how it worked, and I used it to my advantage. I picked up a lucky card here and there. That kind of shit. I had the first few levels, I kept going back to the first level, and basically, I'm calling it that in the game. There's more than one level. There's games inside the game, inside the game. You know what I mean? But, like, It doesn't matter. I'm not trying to use a pun. I don't want to try to take too much energy or thought to come up with an analogy to that part. But anyway, I love you guys, and I need to meditate and take a nap. Peace.